to be here, Jacob. Thanks a lot. You said Indo-American chamber, but you know, Mr. Trump and Ms. Merkel don't get along so well. But me and Rajamani, we just looked at each other and we quickly figured out. So between us, it was pretty easy to manage. You know, life is mean. The last weeks, I've been doing a lot of startup pitches with the Consul General. And I always used to think, what do these, they must be under so much pressure. They have a time limit, 3 minutes. And now I'm on the other side because of this time limit. Yeah, so you've put us already under pressure. 10 minutes, that's quite long. I'll finish earlier. Yeah, so what do I make my pitch about? How can I bring some value to this forum? I'm going to talk about the country I have been working for the last 15 years, which has given me everything. It has, besides my career, it has given me also a way that how can we learn from them and implement some good stuff in the country which I was born in. You know, so let me just share some thoughts with you. Out of the 1,700 German companies which are active in India, 1,700, 200 are from this city, this state, which is the second biggest concentration in India, after Pune. Now, why are they here? Not for the good weather, certainly not for the craft beer every few kilometers. They are here because the city has provided them the necessary ecosystem. The market is here. They get engineers. You have to train them a bit. But you do get the necessary inputs, and that is why the companies have done exceedingly well in this region of Karnataka. Some of the companies like Bosch and Festo actually started in the 50s and 60s. Really long, many years ago. In fact, when Infosys was beginning in 1980-81, some of the initial business they did was with Bosch, actually. So this is one of the reasons why it gave them the impetus to become the company they have become. Most of these 200 companies are actually in the field of engineering, machine tools, machine building, research and development, and of course, IT and software, you know, the backbone of the Karnataka ecosystem. But apart from that, specific to this topic, many of the companies also offer solution for smart cities. In fact, what I can actually bring to the table here is what we also tried, what Jacob mentioned, since almost 2 years, is that we've shortlisted about 15 companies from our member base, about 500 members, who can actually provide solutions to smart cities. So we've made a kind of an Indo-German consortium. And I wish that we can, together with the help of you all, and you know, somehow take it to the next level. Take it to the policymakers, take it to the government, and show them that this is what you can achieve if we all just sit together and have a clear intention and a clear will. So there's a lot that can be done through the help of the technology that these companies have to offer. I hope I'm not speaking something which maybe Margaret will speak, but then I think as I'm learning in my German lessons, repetition is sometimes good. You know, it never harms. Germany on a national level is actually collaborating with 3 smart cities, Bhubaneswar, Coimbatore, and Kochi, where, of course, the projects are very much at an advanced stage also. A little few words about what my organization does, because eventually my job is to let people sit across each other, let people talk, and so basically we are matchmakers. We build a network, we let people connect people. So we were established 63 years ago in 1956. We are called the Indo-German Chamber of Commerce. We are by far the biggest binational chamber in the world. So Dhiraji, at least one number one. we have 6,000 members. We have 6 offices, 120 colleagues. What do we do? We bring delegations from Germany to India, also in the field of smart city. And we will have one delegation in about 4 weeks on civil security. So if there's anyone who's in the business of products for making the city safe, please feel free to get in touch with us. We have a small booth outside. My colleagues will be there today and tomorrow. We are also very active in the startup space. Thanks to, again, the Consul General, who is very passionate about the topic. We try and bring startups together and connect them to the German corporates through our network of Big Sun. Big Sun is Bangalore Indo-German Startup Network. And the idea is that the German companies, which in this space are need a little bit time to work with startups, we are trying to make that time shorter so that they can look at this possibility a bit more quickly and a bit more openly. We do business partner search. We can connect you to the right people in Germany. We do it the other way around also, Germans connecting to India. We are very active in the field of training, both for blue-collared workers and white-collared people also. We have the Indo-German Training Center, where we have an MBA program. So we are trying to bridge the skill divide also. So I can go on, but I don't want this to be a marketing pitch, certainly not. One more point I want to make, about, from my perspective, the perhaps the first collaboration which took place between India and Germany to make a city smarter. Our city, Bangalore City, which I'm proud to live in, any guess when this collaboration happened? Which year it may have happened? At least to my knowledge, this was a cooperation. Any guess? 10 years, 15 years, 20 years? Okay. Yes? 30 years. It happened 111 years ago, in the year 1908, when the King Krishna Raja Vodiyar, he commissioned a German botanist to take over the Lal Bagh. And he came here, and absolutely right, Gustav Hermann Krumbigel. He came here and made this beautiful garden, which we all enjoy. Not only the garden, he was involved in city planning and architecture. So some of the beautiful avenues which we pass by on a Sunday maybe, then you can really, marvel at the city. And a bit of the credit goes to a German. So, what I want to emphasize here is that here we have the technological know-how. We know how to do things in a good way. And that is the benefit of working with Germans. And I hope it is not, my talk is not sounding like a history lesson. But I think there's a lot that can be done. And if you want to know more, I'm here today and tomorrow. My colleagues are here. We also have a book outside by Ferdinand Kurt Heller, the man who started the chamber in India in 1956. He could already envision that this country is the future. And Germany should have a strong presence here. He started coming here in the early 50s. And today, we are a big family of 6,000 companies, 150 people. So there's a lot that we can do together. And one note on Jacob, I would really love to mention, he's not only a good event organizer, he's a wonderful human being also. Unfortunately, I was flying to Delhi on 2nd December. My mother had passed away. And I noticed he's in the same flight. And of course, he could see that I'm in a little bit of a bother, a difficult thing. And I told him, and would you believe it, at 4 in the afternoon, I saw him at the cremation ground. And he canceled all his meetings in Delhi to be with me that day. And I will never forget that. So we are in good hands with Jacob. And I think he can really bridge and take us this difficult road of implementing our projects through layers and layers of, I don't want to mention, we may soon have a 2.0 government here also, maybe, HDK 2.0, we will see in a few hours. But I think he's the right man to take us forward and help us achieve what we all want to do. Thanks a lot. I'm well within my time. Thanks a lot. Thank you.